ask you a question now with all this experience. What do you think about accreditation for PR professionals? Do you see this as something that is necessary for the field, similar to medical accreditation?
Well, it's, you know, it's a, I think it's a lofty ambition. A lot of people think that we need it. I don't know how practical it is. There's no certification to be a CEO because there's broad responsibilities. So the public relations professional is the only person in the organization who has a similar set of roles as the CEO, touching on everything in the company. And so how do you train for that? I mean, how do you certify for that? Well, you have some basic things, but most of all, you have to know about the business you're in. So how do you certify someone to know about Merrill Lynch or about Owens? I mean, it's just hard. If you're looking for background requirements today, if you don't have an MBA in business, no matter what field you're in, you're probably missing a bet. And liberal arts background, professional experience in communications, an MBA is probably the best bet going forward. I had a journalism degree and that was great. But I would guess you can make a case for a liberal arts background too against that. But I'm on the development board at University of Illinois, so I don't want to say this too loudly, they won't like that. But Illinois does a great job. It's just I've been on the advisory board at Medill at Northwestern. So I'm deeply involved in journalistic education. But I am saying that you can come from another space too to be successful in the field. But knowledge of business and the company you're in is absolutely essential. Because without that as a given, you can't even sit at the table. So you have to be credible about the business.
Have you had any experiences going into a classroom situation talking to students about?
I've had some. I've been back to Illinois a couple times. Haven't done a lot of that. No, maybe I'll do more of it now, but I haven't really done a lot of that. So,
do you think that today's students graduating in public relations are ready for ethical decision making as they, you know, first start out and work their way through the business world?
You know, I think so. I just haven't had enough exposure to that. Although we recruit at Accenture, we recruit a lot of people, so I get exposure to graduates that way, and I find today's graduate quite ethical. The ethical communication, ethical business to me is, well, of course. I mean, you don't go to business today in a large company without being ethical. It's a given. I mean, it's a price of entry. It's not a plus. I mean, if you're not ethical, you're not going to survive today in a transparent world. So I think the young people coming into business get it. I think they understand that. So.
Okay, good.
They certainly see enough headlines about people who are not ethical, so
yes.
They ought to get that message, right?
Right.
The media
yeah.
do not let up on this, so.
No, let's just go take a look at mission statements in creative.
Right.
Go back to Owens Corning and Beatrice and Merrill Lynch.
Mm-hmm.
Did they have codes of ethics? And also when you were there, and also now with Murphy and Company. Did you have formalized staff training to promote ethical behavior?
I'm trying to recall. I know all of them had mission statements and ethical standards, no question about that. Certainly Accenture has extensive training in ethical behavior, and Merrill Lynch does too, I'm sure, because they have all the compliance issues they have because they're a regulated company by the federal government. So there's all sorts of training around that at Merrill Lynch. I think, I can't remember, frankly, at Beatrice and Owens Corning if there was formal training, but there was certainly formal communications about it all the time. And there was, you signed a document every year about your pledge to be, you know, the code of ethics. But I can't remember, frankly, whether it was training or not, so.
Okay. What about Murphy and Company?
Well, we're small, we're 75 people, and we have a code of ethics, but we don't have any formal training classes, in a sense, because we communicate regularly about it, and a training class didn't seem to be necessary, so. But if we got larger, we would have to do that, I'm sure.
Mm-hmm.
So, all right.
Well, I mean, you've sort of answered this, but do you feel it's pretty important for a corporation, whatever size it is, to have an ethics or mission statement?
I mean, it's like having a profit and loss statement. There's not an option to it.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, it's sort of when you talk to someone in the public relations business and they don't say to you, well, that's a given, then they don't get it. I mean, you have to have a set of ethics today. It has to be enforced. But, I mean, it's not like something that's, it's an idea someone does. I mean, you just do it. I mean, it's not a program like someone has an idea to do it. I mean, and at the end of the day, why, how else could you operate? Today's transparency of big companies, there's no choice about it. So it's what you do beyond the standard ethics. It's where you pay back to society. It's how you direct your investments. It's how you treat your people beyond the ethical behavior, beyond the ethics of it all. It's how you think about your clients and your customers. It's how you treat your suppliers. It's well beyond ethical behavior. It's just being a solid citizen and how you operate around the world. Interesting enough, I'm connected with Public Relations Coalition, and we've done something around Brand America, because it's suffering in recent years. And what American businesses do around the world in terms of community service and if you would, ethical behavior, is so far outshining any other country's businesses, it's unbelievable. I mean, American business operate at such a high ethical level in comparison to most companies in the world, it's remarkable. And I don't think we get a lot of credit for that.
Have you been in the classroom?
I haven't, but I've had people who work for me in extensive networking in classrooms, mm-hmm. and at networking events, job fairs, and that type of thing. So, no, we've been, actually, I'm gratified with the success we did make. But it took special effort.
Right.
So, right.